Day two of the government shutdown and still no sign of compromise out of Washington. Republicans proposed a plan Tuesday to get parts of the budget funded, but Democrats quickly rejected the measure, once again refusing to negotiate.
The newest Republican plan would reopen portions of the government, like national parks, veteran services, and the District of Columbia. But a two-thirds vote was needed to send the bill to the Senate. And House Democrats refused to get on board.
They took hostages by shutting down the government, and now they're releasing one hostage at a time.
Republicans say Democrats and the White House refuse to even hear their efforts to negotiate.
As you know, the House has proceeded in five different fashions to try and resolve this situation and not to end up here. But at each and every turn, the Senate Democrats refused to even discuss these proposals and instead tabled every one of them.
Republicans are seeking delays on parts of the president's health care reform. They also want to get rid of Congress's exemption to Obamacare. Earlier Tuesday, the Senate rejected a House request to begin a conference committee with members from both chambers to try and resolve the party's differences. Meanwhile, 800,000 federal workers are at home without pay. President Obama warns a prolonged shutdown could have a bad effect on the economy.
It would throw a wrench into the gears of our economy at a time when those gears have gained some traction.
But Phil Kirpin, president of American Commitment, says investors don't appear to be concerned.
This is certainly not new territory. This is something we've been through many, many times before. And, the stock market basically shrugged it off today, which I think tells you a lot about how investors are viewing this.
Meanwhile, some Republicans are starting to break ranks and calling for legislation to fund the government with no conditions.
I think this shutdown's a bad idea, and I want a clean CR.
Another approaching deadline raises the stakes for lawmakers to end their current standoff. October 17th, the country will run out of money to pay its bills and default unless Congress raises the debt ceiling.